All right, mesdames and messieurs, in this video, we're gonna look at the color grading panel in Lightroom. It totally changed a few months ago, and I wanna show you what it does. It's really cool to give like a special look to your photography. Let's do it. All right, so here I am in Lightroom, and before I show you the color grading, I wanna show you something that I think is one of the main reasons this panel exists, which is what I call the Hollywood look or the orange and teal look. For example, you can see here, Born Identity, great film with Matt Damon. You see how it's very blue. It's actually teal. It's between blue and green. And here is very orange. And this is from Transformer. You see how everything, like all the shadows are very teal. And how he's like, look how yellow and orange he is. Or this is from Mad Max. You can see here, like, look at his skin, how he's yellow. And you can see here, there's a bit of green in his shadows there. Or this is from Game of Thrones. I mean, look at this. It's just like two color theme, teal and orange. That's it. You know, even covers of, you know, like this is teal, orange, and this is blue. So what's the big deal about this teal orange thing? Why is that? Well, let's go over to Adobe Color. Adobe Color, but it's a great site to look at the color wheel, color.adobe.com. And I'm going to go to complementary. Complementary means two colors which are opposite on the wheel. And the theory is very simple. This is the skin tone here, okay? So the skin tone, this is what the skin tones are in most Caucasians, and the opposite is teal. So the idea is that if you have basically something that's very orange, and then in the back it's something very blue, then you kind of stick out. For example, like this. You see how now I'm like very sort of Hollywood look in the video. I added some blue in my video and some orange on my skin to make this sort of Hollywood look. Let's go back to normal. Now, let's talk about the color wheel. So the color wheel is this, it used to be called split toning, and now it's here. It's called color grading now. And basically what it does is you got three wheels, shadow, highlights, and midtones. Let's look at shadows first. Basically shadows, well, let's retouch this photo just a little bit. This is a photo from Soho in New York. And I want to give like this very Hollywood look to it. So I'm going to open the shadows. I'm going to bring down the highlights a bit. I'm going to do some black, some white, you know, maybe make it a little more bluish, maybe a bit more brighter, a little bit more blue. And then let me crop it because it's too much of that foreground. I love Soho in New York. It's a great place to take photos. It's got a great vibes to it. Okay, so, but now I want to make this, it's coming out of a movie. So I'm going to crop it 16:9 really quick. That's gonna help make sell it as a movie. And voila. So now let's go back to our color grading here. And so shadows, well, very simple. You see, if I go all the way here, I'm gonna overdo it so you can see. I'm adding a lot of blues, but only in the shadows. Look here in the darkest part here. And you can go around like this, around the wheel, and now I'm adding red, I'm adding orange, I'm adding green, you know, and between green and blue is teal, the famous Hollywood color. Okay, so you can, usually what I do is I go all the way, and then you have this little tool here where it creates a line, and that's the saturation. In the middle, you're almost not using that color, and as you go more outside of the circle, you're using it more. So I advise you not to use it too much. But you see now I'm adding some blue and some tilt. Maybe let's go a little more teal in the shadows. Maybe let's add a little more. And then I can do the opposite with the highlights. So the highlights is the same thing. Let me maybe overdo it. So look in the highlights, anything which is bright in a photo. And I'm going to move around. See, I'm adding orange. I'm adding yellow. I'm adding green. I'm adding blue. So if you want to go for the matrix looks, you can add both green in the highlights and the shadows. But I want to go for more Hollywood looks. So I'm going to go the opposite. I'm going to go here in the orange section. And I'm going to back it down also. Now, one new addition they added to this really cool thing is you have the ability, you see dark and white, to make your shadows darker or brighter. So whatever you did there, it's going to add on top of that, which is a great way to refine things. So, okay, so maybe I'm going to make this a bit, a bit darker. Maybe I'm going to make this a bit brighter. You see how that's swimming just to highlight, okay? And then we've got the mid-tones. So the mid-tones is is going to influence the most of photos. So let's overdo it to see. See, now I'm going magenta. It's adding magenta sort of everywhere, orange everywhere, yellow everywhere, green everywhere. I usually don't touch. If I double click, it puts it back in the middle. I usually don't touch this wheel. You know, you could go and add some kind of look to it. You know, like films, for example, used to have a lot of very color cast like that. You can do that if you want. Same thing, you can open the mid-tones. You can open the mid-tones a little bit here. And voila. Now, you can also just click here to just do the shadows, the mid-tones, or the highlights. Or you can click here and you have all three, which is what I like to do here. Okay, and you also have this option here, which is the global. So global is going to change the entire photo. It's kind of like mid-tones on steroid. I never use global personally, but you can. And then you can also lower, like you can, for example, I can add like a matrix look to everything. And then I'm like, oh, it's too much. And I can lower the luminance. Well, that's the same thing. It's just the overall brightness or darkness of the photo. Again, I'm not using global. I like to go like that. But if you want to see the before and after of any panel in Lightroom, you can go here, before the and after. Let me show you another example. A photo I shot in New York City. This is the RAW file. And then let's go here. I'm going to do a little bit of retouching. I'm going to open the shadows. I'm going to bring down the highlights a bit. White, black, add a bit of contrast, exposure, white balance. Yeah, maybe make it a bit warmer, a bit of more magenta. And, you know, I already like it, but let's take it to the next Hollywood level with the color grading. So here on color grading, I'm going to go back to the three adjustments. I'm going to go down here. I made my screen very big so you could really see. So that's why I have to scroll that panel so much. And, you know, it's a very low resolution screen. And then I'm going to add, so, you know, look at this. Adding blue in the shadow is interesting. So that's the Hollywood look. That's a different kind of look. But Hollywood sometimes does blue. Like, look at this. Like, for example, Christopher Nolan added more blue here. Michael Bay added more green. Game of Thrones more green. This was more green. So, but it's always kind of a cold color in the shadows. It's kind of the same idea. So let's go Dark Knight. The Dark Knight Rises. So not so much, a little bit. Let's do like a Dark Knight photo. And then I'm going to, in the highlights, I'm going to add some yellow, orange maybe. And then voila. Let's see the before, any after. Oh, by the way, I'm going to show you on portraits how to do it. But before that, if you can do me a huge favor and smash that like button, that'd be amazing because other people can find about the video. It just takes 2 seconds. You just press on that like button and leave me a comment. Tell me what you want to learn. Every week, I try to do 2 videos per week. It's a game I'm playing. So leave me a comment. Tell me what you would like to learn. Tell me what you think about this video. You know, what other topics on Lightroom, Photoshop you want to learn. And also, if you want to speed up your workflow in Lightroom, I have something really cool for you. It's just one sheet of paper that you can print called the 13 best shortcuts you must know. The link is under this video. Click the link, just put in your email and first name and last name. You're going to get some amazing news from me. I'm going to send you lots of news from me, but you're going to get some incredible deals you can only get through my newsletter. And you're going to get this really cool sheet. You can print it. And if you know the 13 shortcut, it's going to speed up by 2 at least your work on Lightroom. It's really cool to have. Try to force yourself to use these shortcuts. I made a video about it. It must be somewhere around here. It's really, really cool. All right, so now let me show you on portrait. So this is a photo of my daughter Marine. I dressed her up like as a vintage photographer from the 20s with like my old 4x5 camera. And love this photo, my beautiful Marine. I'm just doing a basic retouching. But again, very classic, you know, the Hollywood looks great in portrait. It gives this, you just move this to the color you want. So try blue and green. I mean, you can go the opposite. You can make this like very vintage. You know, I can make like a vintage look by adding warmth in the shadows. I don't have to go for that Hollywood look. So let's try that look. And then let's try adding the opposite. Let's try adding a little bit of blue in the shirt. It's kind of weird, but why not? Let's check it out. Before, after. Yeah, it's kind of weird. I think the Hollywood look is going to work better. So let's go back to the tilt. Not so much. And then let's go back to the orange, something like that. And now you got a proper Hollywood look. Yeah, you see, that's really the sort of the Hollywood look. I mean, they really overdo it. Look how yellow she looks. She looks like sick. But we get so used to it, you know. I don't like to go so strong. On movie, it's kind of fine. On photo, I think it's too much. You know, like if I would go like something like that, you know, and then what they do also is they, you know, they go in the skin here. I can double click and add like some yellow to make it even more with a filter. You know, that's kind of almost too crazy. I'm going to use a luminance mask so that I'm more just on her face a little bit like that, or actually the opposite like that. But, you know, it's way too much. I don't want to use a circle. Yeah, it's way too much. I think this is kind of cool. Let me show you another photo of Marine. Let me reset it. Cool photo of Marine dressed up as a cowboy. So open the shadows, boost the whites. Not going to touch the helmet, the exposure, crush the blacks. You know, I like the white balance. It's pretty cool. And now let's do a little bit of Hollywood look. Okay, so I'm going to add a bit of... Look at that. Right away, it looks like a movie. Bing. You know, like that. And like that. Some oranges. And just like that, you get this really cool look. I never really use the mid-tones. I mean, you can go around and maybe make the mid-tones even more orange if you want to go crazy. Check it out. Before, after. You know, it's a look. You know, you got to love it. But again, you don't have to do that. You know, it just... adds a little thing, so you can, you know, I can reset this, and I can go for a vintage look. I can just add some, you know, some warm in the shadows, and then and do nothing in the highlights, and make, you know, maybe here adds, you know, just some. Let's see here, what else can we do? You just move it around and see if there's something that you like. No, nothing that I like here in the mid-tone. So all I did here on this one was add some warm in the shadows. It gives a little je ne sais quoi to your photo. That's the color grading tool in Lightroom. It's fun. It's kind of a one trick pony, I find. But tell me, maybe you've got a better use for it. Download my Lightroom shortcuts. It's going to change the way you use Lightroom, and I'll see you in another video. Mesdames et messieurs, au revoir.